polluted due to the thermal power plant and various number of vehicle uses. So here we can use the electric vehicle. Nowadays it is electric vehicles we can use, so that we can reduce the release of CO2 gas due to the vehicle, or burning of fossil fuels we can reduce by using the electric vehicles. It's one step. Then next, after reducing the fossil fuel use, we can reduce the diseases like asthma and lung cancer. That means these are the effects of fossil fuels on the human health. Okay, next one is impact on aquatic life by oil spill. So here see, due to the high demand of the uncountable demand of the fossil fuels, they have to transfer from one place to another place. One place to another place via sea. So while it is running in the sea, due to the, and this is filled with crude oil. Crude oil means unrefined oil. If the crude oil leaks in the sea, it will mix with the sea water, and due to the mixing of the crude oil, the aquatic lives also don't get the oxygen. So due to absence of oxygen, they will dead. So this is the impact on aquatic life by oil spill. Oil spill means the crude oil, it is very dangerous because it is a unrefined oil. Due to the transfer of the non-renewable energy or fossil fuel from one place to another place via sea, there will be some leakage of the oil or crude oil, and due to that unrefined oil, the life of the aquatic animals may be dangerous. So these all four points, or you can say environmental hazard, acid rain, effect on human health means diseases like asthma and lung cancer, or impact on aquatic life, means we can conclude it that by using the different types of fossil fuel, you can say it coal or oil or natural gas, after burning it for producing energy, it is dangerous for the environment also, for human, for aquatic life, and it is dangerous for what? The trees, means plants, and human also, diseasing the humans. Okay, so next we will go for the importance of renewable energy. If we are saying that after burning the fossil fuel, it is impacting the environment and it is dangerous for human health, then we will switch to the renewable energy. So before switching to the renewable energy, we should know what are the advantages or what are the importance of renewable energy. Firstly, we can say they do not use oxygen in particular to produce energy. Before, we already told you that for fossil fuel use, or to burn the fossil fuel, we need oxygen. But it is only to burn the fossil fuel, but to derive the energy or to produce the energy by using renewable energy, it is not needed. That means here it is written, they do not use oxygen in particular to produce energy. Here oxygen is not required for the, or here burning process is not used in case of renewable energy, but in case of fossil fuel, they are all the fossil fuels burn to produce energy, but here they are not burned, that means they are not required oxygen. So secondly, we will go, they do not emit CO2 or any other greenhouse gases. That means after burning the fossil fuel, we know that it releases the CO2 gas. That means CO2 is a pollutant gas, but here in case of renewable energy, there is no burning process, so there will also be no emission of CO2 gases. Another one, it is written that greenhouse gases. So greenhouse gases means you can say methane gas, it is called a greenhouse gas. Carbon dioxide gas, it is also called a greenhouse gas. Then what are the problem with the greenhouse gases? If they are released to the atmosphere, they will increase the Earth's atmosphere. Likewise, another term you can say global warming. Global warming and greenhouse gases or greenhouse effect you can say, due to the global warming or due to these type of gases, there is increase in temperature of the Earth's surface. Due to the global warming or you can say greenhouse effect or greenhouse gases like methane and CO2, there is an increase in temperature of Earth surface. Then what will happen if the temperature of the Earth surface will increase? If it will increase, it will melt the ice present in the Earth. So it will increase the rise the water level, and due to the rise of the water level, there will be chances of flood. Okay, so we have to prevent these two effects, that is you can say global warming and greenhouse effect, and it can be prevented by what? It can be prevented by reducing the fossil fuel use. So there are various problems with use of fossil fuel, so we have to use max to max renewable energy, but there is no burning process and there is no emission of this type of gases which causes global warming and greenhouse effect. Then next one is written, they do not cause major pollution. You all know that they do not produce any pollution. You can say which, take any example for solar energy, you can take wind energy, geothermal energy, you can take any renewable energy, they don't produce the pollution. The next, available freely in nature and in abundant quantity. So here is term written, abundant quantity, that means huge or in larger amount. In huge or larger amount, it is available in the nature, and it is, main point is that it is available in nature freely. That means we have to not give any cost for the this type of sources. Solar, we don't have to give any cost. For wind, we don't have to give any cost. That means they are available in a nature, that means freely available, and in also abundant quantity, that means huge quantity or a large number of amount of quantity, and it is available everywhere. You can say wind available everywhere, solar is available everywhere, so everyone can use the solar energy and wind energy, and also hydraulic is also a renewable energy. It is also available everywhere, that is also freely. The next one you can see, renewable energy is sustainable. So what is sustainable? Another point is there, sustainable design and development, later it is there, what is a sustainable design and sustainable development. Here I am saying just what is, which type of development we will call sustainable development. That means if there is development without harm of the environment, and if it is not reducing the sources, then this type of development will be called as a sustainable development, and this is only possible in case of renewable energy sources. That's why we are calling the renewable energy source as a sustainable source. Okay, so next written, new jobs are created in the field of technology. It is creating new jobs, or in the field of renewable energy there are various jobs nowadays. You can see according to the data of International Renewable Energy Agency, that is you can say according to the International Renewable Energy Agency and the International Labour Organization, that is ILO, there are in 2020 there are 12 million jobs in case of renewable energy sources. 12 million. It is on in 2020 according to the report of the International Renewable Energy Sources and the International Labour Organization. Then it is 12 million in 2020, but in 2019 it is about 11.5 million. That means you can see there is rise in the jobs opportunity in renewable energy sources. It is in 2019 11.5 million and in 2020 it is 12 million. That is, there is rise in the opportunity in case of renewable energy sources 11.5 million to 12.5 million. If you will divide it in the renewable energy, different type of renewable energy sources, in case of solar, it is creating approximately 4 million job opportunity, and in biofuel it is 2.4 million and in wind it is 1.25 million. Okay, so these are the job opportunities. You can switch to the solar or biofuel or wind. So totally, overall, we can say there are 12 million jobs in 2020 according to these organizations annual report. Then next, the economy is boosted. That means economy is boosted. Why it is boosted? Because for the fossil fuel or for the non-renewable energy, we are depending on other countries. Other countries, or we buy the fossil fuels from the other countries. That for the buying of the fossil fuels, we have to give some money. So, but if the renewable energy, they are available freely in nature, so we have to not invest any cost. Okay, so that means the economy is boosted. It is available freely in nature and in huge amount, so we have to not spend any money for buying the energy. But in case of fossil fuel or non-renewable energy, we have to depend on other countries, or we have to buy the you can say coal or oil, buy it from the other countries. That means we have to give some money, or we have to spend some money. That means economy is decreasing in case of non-renewable energy, but here economy is boosted. Then next one, our dependence on conventional sources of energy available in other countries reduced. Here I am saying, it is written, dependence on of conventional sources of energy available in other countries reduced. So this dependency will reduce if we will start using the renewable energy. Then next, we will go for the, what is a sustainable development, design and development. Here this is sustainable design and development. The first point is written, that development that do not harm the environment, and the second one, don't decrease the natural resources. So we have to understand what is its meaning. We will development will be there, but without harming the environment. If this type of development is going on in the country, then we can say that the country is developed sustainably, okay, without harming the environment. The next one, it is saying that it should be, don't decrease the natural resources. We will develop the country or develop the energy production, but without reducing the natural resources. We will use it, but it is also available for the future. Available for future. Because if we will, for the production of energy, if we will use all the resources available here, then our next generation will use for which type of resources? There will be no resources in future. So to remain or to present the available of the resources in the near future or in our next generation, we have to use in such a way that it should be available in for future. That means that type of development we can say it as a pure sustainable development. Okay, so these two points should be there. If this is happening, then this type of development is sustainable development. Next one, it is saying that significant component is renewable energy. So this type of thing, that means we will develop the country or we will produce the energy, but without harming the environment and without reducing the natural resources. So it is only possible in case of renewable energy. But in case of non-renewable energy, you see, it is not possible, because if we will use coal, it will reduce from its total amount. But we will use the coal, that means in our next generation, it may not be available. It will be totally vanished from the earth. It will not be available. But in case of renewable energy, if you are using solar, then it will also available for our next generation. It will be available, always it will be available till the earth exists. So it is saying that significant component is renewable energy. That means sustainable development is only possible in case of renewable energy. It is not possible in case of non-renewable. That means it will reduce from its total amount. Next one, it will always affect or it is always polluted the environment. Then next one is improve economic, social and environmental condition. Okay. So as we know, due to the fossil fuel use, there is energy related environmental problems. So all the developed and developing countries should use the appropriate energy system. So which energy system is called appropriate energy system? We can say renewable energy system. So all the countries should adopt this approach, appropriate energy system. Or so which one is the appropriate? You can say renewable energy is the appropriate energy system. So by why it is called appropriate? By using this energy, you can say our development is sustainable. We are not harming the environment. We are not reducing the natural resources. It is also available for the future. So this is the best approach or best adoption of energy system for every country, either it is developed or developing. The next one we will see, it is written government policies should be carefully planned. Okay, so there are different type of policies for the use of or for the production of energy. So these policies should be carefully planned to develop the or to protect the climate change, to protect the climate change. Or to prevent the climate change, the government policies should be carefully planned. In India, there are various type of policies for the use of or for the production of renewable energy. We will see. So first one you can say that is rooftop PV small scale generated program. Or in short, you can say it as RPSSGP, that means rooftop PV, P for PV, small scale generated program. This is a government policies to which aim that it will produce, that means it will aim that all should encourage to use the renewable energy. all should use the renewable energy at their home. We can use it domestically, we can use it industrially. That means for small value, we can place it at the top of the roof, or we can place it at the bottom. It should be placed to generate the electricity. That means this policy is known as rooftop PV small scale. Small scale written means domestic use. For the domestic use, we can use the solar or PV. PV will, it will be, I will teach you PV in the next. That means PV means photovoltaic. It is used in the solar energy. So by using the solar panel or solar energy, we can generate the electricity in a domestic conditions. That means small scale condition. So this is a RPSSGP government policy. Then another one is solar mission. And it is revised in 2014 that it will produce 100 gigawatt of power by 2022. So this mission is known as solar mission. That means I am saying that the policies should be in every country, the policies should be implemented carefully or implemented strictly, that it should be day by day, it should avoid the use of fossil fuel. That's how you can protect the climate, or you can protect the climate change, you can protect the aquatic life, you can protect the human lives from the threats or from the impacts of the fossil fuel use. Next, investment on industries for clean technology. For which type of development we will call sustainable? One thing is it will not harm the environment, another one is it will not reduce the natural resources. Another one is there, it should be implemented or it should be invested, or our money should be invested in the industries where there is cleaner technology. Nowadays for the development we are using technologies that is harming the environment, but it should be like that, it should be cleaner technology. We will develop the country with cleaner technology. That means it will not affect the environment. If it is affecting, then you cannot say it as a sustainable development. Okay, so it should not be affect the environment. That then only you can say it as a sustainable development. So our money should be, or country's energy sources should be implemented in the industries which is producing cleaner technology, or which is using clean technology for producing the energy. Then low cost energy supply. We should supply low cost. If you are using renewable energy, then we have to give very less amount of cost for the equipments only, because for the source we have to not given any money, because they are freely available in nature. Only for the technologies we have to give some money or cost. So it should be also low cost. If it is high cost, you cannot say it as a sustainable development. It should be low cost energy supply. By using small amount of energy supply, we will generate maximum or larger amount of energy. Then use of domestic energy sources like hydro, wind, solar, etc. That means by using this type of sources, hydro, wind, solar, if we are generating electricity, then this type of development we can call it as a sustainable development or sustainable design. So all the countries should follow these points for developing their energy. They should use max to max the renewable energies so that they will not harm the environment, and also it is boosting the economy, and it is also low cost energy supply as compared to the non-renewable energy. Okay, thank you.